started off by pledging my solidarity to the family and to say that the day of the funeral was one of the most sad and distressing, shocking days of my own life. To see that family, to see a hearse of a 31-year-old man, clearly loved and respected not merely by his family, but by the whole community who had turned out. And to have to look at his little baby, knowing that that baby would never see his father. And to think that is the society in which we live. Graham mentioned Joanna Blythman, whose journalism I think has been fantastic. I'd also like to mention, because it was on that very day, the Herald, because its front page said, cover up. Now, we don't actually have that kind of journalism that often in Scotland, but they're absolutely right. The biggest gang in town is the police. They are institutionally working class. They are backed by all these weapons. They have the power of arrest. They can take away your freedom. And it would seem they can take away your life. And what happens is a cover-up by the state and by all the people in that state, all its functionaries, everyone involved, its flunkies, from its politicians to its lowest flunkies, covering up what is going on here. There is no sub judice here, as they pretend. Oh, we can't speak. We can't talk right now. There's this inquiry. There's that inquiry. How many botched, messed up, corrupt inquiries, which are going to be a whitewash, will these politicians, whom we elect, sit on it and watch them? They were elected to build the new Scotland, actually. This looks like the old Scotland to me, the old Britain to me. This just looks shocking. And I just want to flag up one or two points that have been mentioned. In detention, for instance, you see people, you know, being killed in prisons, being killed. Even if people have been convicted of a crime, we do not have execution in this country. You should not end up dead. They're not allowed to kill you. That is extrajudicial execution. Yes. And we have to stop that. But when it comes to, at least in prison, it's very, very difficult to find out what's going on, but we have a list of everybody. In detention, that's not the case. Umpteen different multinational thug criminal companies run these detention centres. Anyone can get moved round and round and round about. People have come into the country with maybe no family, no friends, not speaking the language, and they don't have a lawyer. Actually, we have no idea who's in these places. Actually, we have no idea who has died in these places. That's the truth of the matter. That is the country that we have. And I would urge you, in terms of detention and asylum, because I come from the Campaign to Welcome Refugees, and of course, Shekru did come from another country, not as a terrorist, as a child. As a child, to get a new life. And he did get a better life. Let's face it was not a wealthy life in terms of riches, but it was a wealthy life in terms of the people he was surrounded by, what he gave to them, what he gave to him. But it has ended up in his death. That is how he came here. Other people come here. They must not be smeared as terrorists. No one should be smeared in that way. People have to be welcomed here the way Shekru should have been properly welcomed here and looked after here. And that is very important for all the demos that happen outside these detention centres. Please turn out for them. What we have to do now, I think, is build this campaign, take it out into all the communities, take it into the wider campaigning atmosphere in this city and this country. It must not be sidelined. It must not be pigeonholed, a little campaign for a sad event. That must not happen. This is crucial to our society, and it should be at the forefront of the St Andrews anti-racist demo. It should be at the forefront of the demo on United Nations Day against racism and fascism. It has to be at the forefront of that. It has to be at the forefront of trade union campaigning. And the campaigning that we take on in the election, it has to be at the forefront of all of that, because this is absolutely crucial. We cannot have this gang of cowboys running about, thinking they can stop and search. We need the proper stop and search figures, by the way, on racial and working class profiling in Scotland and in Glasgow. They think they're stupid. They think we can't count, that the figures they have given us are the proper figures for racial profiling. Go to any meeting on the south side of the city and ask whether or not there is profiling on stop and search. Youngsters, working class youngsters and black people, I'm being told I have to stop. Let's not stop. Let's make this the starting point. Let's make one of our aims, as was suggested in our workshop, a demonstration at that parliament. We pay these people. They are not representing us. They are not building the new Scotland we want. Heaven knows what they are building, their careers, their power, but we will have justice for Sheku, justice for his family, and we will have the better Scotland that we want for the future.